Hey everyone, it is Mona here at Craft Klatch. Today we're going to head up to the kitchen and we are going to make coffee. But you guessed it, it's not coffee that we're going to drink, it's a candle. To make this candle we need to melt some wax, and I have some melting in here already, and I created a double boiler with this craft pitcher. It's a metal pitcher that you could get at the craft store or online. And I will have a link in the description if you are looking for one. And I had some leftover wax that I'm melting. It was actually leftover from the pumpkin pie, but it still wasn't dark enough. And it's hard to get really dark. So the darkest color I could find was a caramel color, and it really doesn't take you all the way there to get that dark. So in addition to that, I'm gonna do some red, some blue, and some yellow in there just to deepen the color. And you're going to just have to kind of experiment with it to get it to the right color. And it's just going to take a little bit of time. But start with less rather than more, because it's really hard. You can't go back. And then you want to add fragrance too. And I found this caramel latte fragrance at the craft store. And I'm sure you could find an actual coffee flavor online. I wasn't able to find it at the craft store. I'm going to add a little bit. So our wax looks pretty dark, but it never hardens that dark because the wax started out white. So to figure out what color it actually is, I'm going to take some wax on my skewer stick and drip it right here on my parchment paper and let it harden, and we'll see how dark it is. I don't think it's dark enough yet. I can see that it's already hardening lighter, so I'm going to add more. And you're just going to need to keep doing that until you get the right color. As you can see, I've tested a bunch of different colors. This is where it started, and then it started to go a little bit red, and then I started getting darker, darker, and darker, and darker, and this is where we're at right now. So I think we're good. The very first thing I have to do is stabilize my wick in the glass. So I'm using more of an Irish coffee glass, but you can use like some fine china ones. Maybe I'll do that in the future. And you could go to like any resale shop or Goodwill or something like that and pick up some mugs or some little china cups and saucers to make candles out of those too. Normally what I would do is I would take the wick and dip it into the wax, but because we have like a little dip in the bottom of the glass, I'm actually going to pour just a little bit in here to help stabilize our wick. Plop that in, and then I've got a couple of stir sticks, and let that harden. Now this is a really great present like for Christmas or any holidays or Mother's Day, but you could get a bunch of these going. Once you get that wax melted in the right color, you can go boom 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 and get a bunch of them done all at once. So the wax on the wick has hardened and now we're in good shape, and I'm going to pour the rest of this in here. Feel about there. Now we just let it harden. Keep an eye on your wick, make sure you keep it straight. This is hardening very nicely. I'm gonna move it off to the side. And I melted, and I just did it in the microwave, some more soap. And I just did it in this little container. And I'm going to just kind of, with my plastic fork, kind of just mix it around as it starts to harden. Because we're going to do the same thing as we did when I did the candle cupcakes. And if you haven't seen that, definitely go watch it. I'm going to pipe some whipped cream on the top. I also did it on the pumpkin pie candle. So as it starts to cool, you're going to start to get pieces on the edge that are going to turn white and harden. I didn't add anything other than scent to this. And as it starts to harden, you're going to want to scrape it from the sides. And it will kind of have a fluffier consistency. See, I'm starting to get it to harden, and all I'm going to do is just keep mixing it around. So we're just about there. And I have a cake decorating tip with a disposable bag that I'm going to use. Okay, I'm going to start putting it in the bag, and I want to get it down there as far as I can, just as though you were piping or frosting a cake or a cupcake. Same way. Okay, now I'm going to pipe this right onto here, like whipped cream. Okay, and then I have a cinnamon stick to kind of finish it off. And you don't have to call this coffee, you can call it hot chocolate. You can call it whatever you want. And I'm going to just put this right in there while this whipped cream is hot. Let it all harden. And we have our little coffee drink. And I'm going to snip the wick, and we're good to go. And it's a perfect gift for the coffee lover in your life. Now, this is still hardening. That's why there's still two tones of the brown. So I hope you like the coffee candle, and I think it would make a perfect gift for the coffee lover in your life. And again, like I said before, you could pass it off as hot chocolate too. You probably would want maybe a chocolatey scent or something like that instead. So I hope you like it, and I hope you give it a try. Be sure to let me know what you think in the comments below. And as always, I always appreciate when you like, comment, subscribe, and share. So thank you guys so much. Happy crafting, and we'll see you next time. Stay safe.